In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use Mocha AE and After Effects to track and composite two titles, each with a different method. By the end, you'll know how to seamlessly integrate them into this shot, along with a few compositing tricks to help the titles blend perfectly with the sand. A lot of users shy away from Mocha AE because of its unique interface and workflow. But trust me, it's one of the best tracking tools available in After Effects, especially when you need to replace screens or attach objects to moving footage. I've covered Mocha AE in depth in other tutorials, which I'll link below, but today we are going to take things in a slightly different direction. If this is your first time here, welcome! I'm Eran, and I've been teaching After Effects for over 30 years. You can explore my full course catalog on LinkedIn Learning, along with tons of free content here on YouTube. All right, so let's get going. I'll preview this composition that I've prepared ahead of time, and by preparing, I mean I have two titles that I want to attach, one for the upper side of the video and the other one on top of the sand underneath the wheels of the Jeep. I'll pause the playback, and before starting to track, I actually want to use a high pass filter to enhance the details and sharpness and isolating the high frequency texture in this image so the tracking result that we'll get from Mocha will be more accurate. Now, as a full disclosure, if you have access to Mocha Pro, then you can use the high pass filter which is embedded in the tool. So I'm quickly going to apply Mocha Pro. Don't worry, you're not going to use it. I just want to show you that assuming you are using the latest version, I'll click on it to launch the interface. Then you have access to a relatively new feature, which is the high pass filter. And to demonstrate how this works, I'm just going to create something that I want to track. And in the track tab, there is a pre-processing button. I'll click on it and here it is. This is the high pass filter. So I can just raise it up and I can also check preview to see how this works. So again, if you have access to it, then go ahead and use it. We are going to assume that you only have access to Mocha AE, so I'll show you how to recreate the high pass filter to get better results. So I'll close this. And by the way, I have a full tutorial of how to create this high pass filter, and the link is over here as well as down below. But for those of you who haven't seen it or just want the short version, I'll open up the effects and presets and I'll type in high pass. And this is going to show the animation preset. Again, I'm showing you how to create it and you can download it from the link in the tutorial I just recommended. But for now, I'll double click on it and you can see that it is basically consists of four effects, the fast box blur, the invert, CC composite and levels. Feel free to pause the video and have a look at the numbers. But the most important bit here is the input black and the input white, which I'm going to drag as close as possible to what I'm seeing here in the histogram. If I switch off the FX icon, there is not a lot of details here compared to what we managed to surface using this combination of effects, also known as a high pass filter. This is especially apparent here in the sand area. Okay, so to track this, first I'll switch off the visibility of those two titles. And then I need to pre-compose this shot. So I'll go to layer and choose pre-compose. I'm going to call it desert, move all the attributes into the new composition and click OK. And now to this comp, I'll apply the Mocha AE effect. And then I'll click the Mocha logo to launch the interface. I'll move the playhead to show you that the area that I'm after is this dent, which was created by the Jeep, but at the beginning, it's not available. So what I think I need to do is start over here by creating an area near the place that I want to track, and then I'll move this to the desired location. So by using the rectangular X spline, I'm tracking this part. I'll switch off the skew, rotation and scale. I'm only after the transformation and I'll start by tracking backwards. And now I'll move the playhead to this keyframe, click on one of the points and then right click and make sure that everything is selected. So I can move this entire shape to the desired area. So something like this, making sure not to include any areas from the Jeep itself. And then I can continue to track from this point onward. And thanks to the high pass treatment that we've created, the tracker has enough details, enough texture to complete the tracking without any problem. Okay, I'll double click on this layer and I'll name this hill. And then I'll go, let's say over here, click on the surface tool and make sure to drag the surface more or less to where you want it to be inside After Effects. So something over here, and then we can move it to see if this is staying in the correct position. And I think it does. All right, this was the easiest part. Now we want to track the part of the sand. So first I'm going to switch off the tracking cogwheel. And this means that Mocha is not going to think about this tracker anymore. It's not going to analyze it. Okay, now I'll move my current time indicator to where I see the Jeep in its full glory, somewhere over here. This is where I want to start tracking this part, the sand. I'll start using the same technique. So I'll switch to the rectangular X spline and create the shape that I want to track. I'll switch off the surface visibility for now, click somewhere else to deselect, and then I'll move this part over here. And by part, I mean, of course, the corner. I'll place this corner over here, this one over here, and this one somewhere over here. Okay, I think that from this point onward, I just want to make sure that the wheels of the Jeep are not intersecting here. So from this point onward, I'm going to enable perspective and just track forward. This is the easiest part because nothing is really moving here. Then I'll go back to the same keyframe and I'll start tracking backward. So I'll click on Analyze Backward. And the moment that I'm seeing the surface is going to go outside of the frame, I'm going to leave it like so. Mocha can still handle it. But if you are worried and if there are not enough pixels, then you can hold down X to pan up and you can change this area after the fact. So what I'll do here is again, click outside to make sure that I'm not selecting all the points, just the ones that I need. And I'm just going to drag these ones over here, as well as give the tracker a little bit more pixels area to work with. And then I'll track or analyze backwards. And this should give Mocha enough pixels to track all the way back to the beginning. I don't think that we need all of these pixels, but let's judge how this looks by going back to this point and then re-enabling the surface tool and positioning it the way we like. So this is what we are going to export out from Mocha to After Effects. In other words, this is where the title is going to be. I do want it to be underneath the Jeep wheels. So I'll stretch it even further. And then it's difficult to judge how this looks. So I'll switch to the layer properties and then I'll use the 16 by 16 grid to help me judge the result. Okay, something like this I think works. Let's see it in action. I'm going to play forward and then Mocha is going to bounce back and continue to play, but in reverse. All right, I think we are ready to name this one Sand, save our tracking data and close Mocha. This is the difficult part. We finished with the tracking and now we are ready to composite those two titles inside After Effects. Okay, so this is the fun part. First, we need to return to this composition, switch off the effects that we've created for the high pass filter. And then we start with this title, Abu Dhabi Desert Challenge. I'll go back to the Mocha AE effect, open up the tracking data, and click on Create Track Data. Since we have two trackers, we are going to see the layer controls menu, and we can select which one we want to use. We'll start with the hill, I'll select it and click OK. And for this one, we only want to use the transform options. So make sure to select it from the pop-up menu, and the layer to export to is my first title. And then I'll click Apply Export. I'll press Spacebar to preview how this looks. All right, I think I need to modify it just a touch, so I'll select it here in the timeline. I'll open its settings, and first, I'll change the anchor point. Notice the position, scale, and rotation all has keyframes, so I don't want to touch them. But the anchor point is still free, so I can move it. And let's say that I want to give myself a bit more spacing between the words. How to do it in After Effects? There is a trick. I'll click on this Animate menu and choose Tracking. For the tracking amount, I can set the tracking, but as you can see, this changes the tracking, the spacing between the characters. So let's open up the Range Selector 1 options, and then the Advanced, and then we'll change it from based on characters to words. It still doesn't work because we also need to change the mode from Add to Subtract. And this is going to actually use the spacing between the words and will help us by changing the tracking amount to extend the spacing between the words themselves. So I'm going to settle for 20 here, and then I'll close the text properties as well as lower this title to somewhere close to the horizon. I'm also going to change the blending mode to multiply. And let's go back to the beginning and test how this looks. I actually want this interaction between the car and the desert world. We'll return to it and we'll rotoscope the car in a later stage, but for now, I think we are ready to move to the second title. Remember, the second title needs to be somewhere over here. Now, the first thing that we need to do is to make sure that the layer that we are applying the corner pin data effect, the distort effect, is the same size as the composition. This is going to give us the most predictable results. And to achieve that, make sure the layer is selected, then go to the layer menu, and under transform, you can select fit to comp. This is going to fit this title to the edges of the comp. Now, let's pre-compose this layer, and we'll call it title, making sure to move all the attributes. This is actually the only option that we have, and we can click OK. Now, back inside the Mocha effect, we'll need to click again on Create Track Data. This time, we want to use the Send, and click OK. You will see a preview of those four corners, and we'll need to change the Export option to Corner Pin, or if you want, you can use Corner Pin with support to motion blur. There isn't a lot of motion blur going on here, so I'll just select corner pin in this instance. And finally, I'll make sure that I'm selecting the correct layer. So layer number 2 in my case, and I'll click export. I can now return to this layer and let's change its blending mode to multiply as well. Go to the start and preview again to see how both of the titles are moving perfectly with the shot. Now, there are a few things that we can do to improve this, especially when it comes to making it look more connected to the scene, as well as, of course, rotoscope the Jeep, so it will cover both of those titles. Let's start with a few distortion effects that will make it look like it is part of the scene texture. I'll select the effect controls, and I'll add the turbulence displace effect and change the size of it to 20. Now, whatever I'm doing, I need to apply these effects before the corner pin. This is really important. Otherwise, we'll have the distortion and then the effect is going to take place. So right now we are seeing it is contributing to the texture of the text itself. But I think we can make it even better by applying a roughen edges effect. Again, it needs to be before the corner pin. And maybe even before the turbulent display, so it's up to you, you can play with them. I'll change the edge type to rusty, and the border here, let's take it to 10. And I came to these values by trial and error. I'll close both of these guys, and then I'll apply a Gaussian blur effect before the corner pin, and change it to 5, just to tone down those two displacement effects. And if you want, you can also move the title just a bit or scale it by using a transform effect, once again, before the corner pin effect. So this is going to allow you to change the scale as well as move the title. So maybe you want to push it just more underneath the wheels of the Jeep and everything should still stick into its place. Now let's quickly rotoscope the Jeep. by selecting the desert layer, duplicating it, placing this above everything. I'm also going to rename it Roto. I'll take away the mocha effect from this clip, and I'll move the current time indicator over here so I can see the Jeep in its full glory. And then I'll hold down Option and double click on this comp to open it in the layer viewer, because this is where we can use the Roto brush tool. So I'll switch to the Roto brush tool and I'll start painting with the green brush, trying to teach After Effects what I want to include. Hold down Option to take away the parts that I don't want. And once we're happy, we can press Spacebar and watch as After Effects propagate forward, and when it goes to the end, backward, and cut away the sand, leaving us only with the outline of the Jeep. If we are happy from what we are seeing, I highly recommend to freeze the result. So I'll click over here, wait for a few more moments as After Effects is going to cache those frames and bake them into the project file. Once this process has finished, we can close the Roto layer and we can have a look at the result. Actually, this is the intermediate result. There's still something that we can do to improve the integration between the title and the sand texture. And to achieve that, I'm going to duplicate another instance of the desert. And this one is going to be just above the title. I'm going to call it Extract after the effect that I'll apply. Let's delete the mocha effect and apply the Extract effect, which is something very similar to the Blend If in Photoshop, and I've demonstrated in few of my tutorials. So let me show you how this looks. I'll start by clicking on this upper square and moving it to the right until I'll see the underneath layer, in my case the title, so something like this. And then I'll click on the lower rectangle, which controls the black softness, and move it to the left. Now, what I'm looking for is something in between that will bring back some of the sand texture on top of the title. So something along those lines. Now, if I move my current time indicator, because the light in the scene is changing, we actually need to animate the black point of the extract effect. So I'll go back to between 6 and 7 seconds. I'll create a keyframe for the black point. And over here, when the exposure is different, I'll move it to compensate. Then I'll continue until the end, and if there's a need, I'll move it slightly more. I'll do the same thing for the beginning of the clip. So over here, I need to actually move it in the opposite direction. And I think this looks correct. Let's just preview it and see how this works together with the other effects. And if there's a need, maybe over here, I'm going to just fix it as I go, trying to keep the same levels for the title transparency. All right, I think that this is it. So I'll maximize the composition panel and let's preview the result. And that's a wrap. By using the high pass filter, we've achieved more precise tracking results, and with a few compositing tricks, we created seamless and convincing shot that could easily be used in a trailer, teaser, or whatever project you are working on. I hope you can apply these techniques to your own work, and if you're eager to dive deeper into Mocha AE, click on this next video and I'll see you over there.